Alright guys, so this is a video response to a YouTuber called Lawnboys Post 1975, I think his name is. It's not a new video at all, we actually posted this sometime at the beginning of the year, but I've only just come across his channel and I've only just watched the video, so it's new to me. Chances are it's probably new to you as well. This video interested me because gamers find bragging rights in the amount of games that they have played. Now, I'm sad to say that I probably do as well. You don't have a collection like that and not go, oh yeah, I've played that. Talking about stuff you haven't played, well, is very hard to do because you haven't played it, you have very little experience with the title. And two, it's just not something we like to do. But, so yeah, it's something you don't hear about. I struggled to find 10 I hadn't played, I must say. I know there's fucking thousands of games I haven't played out of there, but I think personally I've played most games worth playing. Now, I've managed to get a list down of 10 that I haven't played that surprised me, mainly because I own all bar two of them, and I'm just going to run these down in no particular order. Probably not going to say much about any of them, but the first one is the first three Ratchet and Clank games, which is shocking to me because I adore platformers, and I actually really like the look of Ratchet and Clank. I've just never got around to playing it. Next, in a similar way to Ratchet and Clank, is the Jak and Daxter series. I've played one of them, but I've never played 1-2, which again is shocking to me because I just love platformers, and it's Jak and Daxter 1 that always appealed to me the most, and I think I played the third one, which didn't live up to my expectations, but the first one still looks better. Next is a really surprising one to me because this game is just me all over from the look of it, and it's Ico. As you saw from my last pickup video, I own it. There's no reason for me not to play it, I just haven't. Next is a game I don't actually own, and is not very surprising to me that I don't own, because I don't even know if it ever came out in this country. I'm probably going to say this wrong. I think it's Doshin the Giant, or Doshin the Giant, for Nintendo GameCube. I was, at the time of its release, or at the time it was first announced and was supposed to be released, it's all that was on my mind. I really wanted to play it. It is the game I wanted for the GameCube at that point in time, but then I think it got delayed and delayed again, and my interest just died out for it, and eventually I forgot about it. And just looking through my old magazines trying to find games that I haven't played, that's one that stuck out to me, and I would love to get my hands on a copy of Doshin the Giant, or Doshin the Giant, or however I'm not saying it. Next is a very surprising game. It's Silent Hill. Any of the Silent Hill games. I own two of them for the PlayStation 1. And I've just never played them. I love Resident Evil. To me, Silent Hill was the opposite end of the spectrum. You either liked Silent Hill or you liked Resident Evil, and I was always Resident Evil. I should really get on and play Silent Hill because I can imagine really getting into it. Next is any of the Max Payne series. I mention this now because obviously Max Payne 3 has just come out. But yep, never played it, don't know anything about it. To be honest, it doesn't look like it's up my street. I will get number 3 when it comes out, play through that, and then probably play through the first two after, just because it's the new ones on the 360, and that's clearly my platform of choice at the moment. Next is Minecraft. Now, I know why I haven't played this game. I do own it. I bought it with intent to play it with an old friend from work, but I just never got round to it, because I know that game will eat my life away, and I'm glad I haven't played it. I kind of hope I never play it, especially while I'm unemployed, because I can't deal with another game eating up that much of my time. No game is worth that amount of time. Next is Okami. Now, I love Amoratsu as a character. I pick him quite a lot in the Marvel vs. Capcom series, but just never played the game. Next is Battletoads. Heard so much about Battletoads, never ever played it. I love the artwork style on the box art, that's about as much as I can say about it. I really need to play it though, there's definitely no excuse for that one. I could probably complete it in a couple of hours, no doubt. I'm probably going to get a load of comments saying Battletoads is hard. No, you won't. Either way, there's just no excuse for it. I do own it. Next is GoldenEye 007 on the Nintendo 64. Just never played it. I've been around people playing it. I've just never played it myself. I was always a Perfect Dark guy, and GoldenEye just didn't make the cut. I'm not a big James Bond fan, so yeah, that game just slipped right under the radar for me. I remember watching people play it and just being disinterested. It's a first person shooter, and at that point in my life I was definitely all about platform games. Anything with a gun in, not interested. It still am to a certain extent, but you're kind of forced to play first person shooters a lot more these days due to the bloody influx of them. But yeah, I think that's 10 games that I haven't played. Go check out Lawn Boy's post, 1975. I've probably said that wrong, but I find it really hard to read that name for some reason. Some names you just can't read. He's got more subscribers than me, so if you subscribe to me, you probably already subscribed to him. But if you haven't, go check him out. He's a cool guy. He does some pretty good videos. Anyway, cheers, guys.